You're French national, Sandrine. You met your husband while he was on death row. How did that happen?
Yeah, that's correct. We met on when he was on death row. I started getting involved with a very unique organization that was set up by death row inmates in Texas, and it was run from death row at the time when they were not in isolation. It was called the Lamp of Hope, and I started translating their newsletter. And a friend of mine said to me, well, you know, if you want to correspond, I think there's two or three people you would get on with, and Hank was one of them. Then that was in 1996.
Why would you marry someone on death row?
It's a very long story. The marriage is really part of our personal life. I've been a long-time abolitionist long before I met Hank, and I will be long after if he is to be executed. The reason we did marry, first of all, is because we love each other, and it's because I wanted to carry his name. We felt that if he was going to be executed, I would fight to get the DNA testing done, to preserve the evidence, to clear his name, to get to the truth, which at the moment we are no way near.
We're going to hear from Hank in a minute, but Curtis, how did you get involved in this?
Well, principally because I myself was on death row, and it wasn't until the advent of DNA testing that I began to have any hope that I was going to obtain my own freedom. It took many more years, but it did happen, and that's why I'm here, is to represent that principle that law enforcement has a continuing obligation at all times, even post-conviction, to do DNA testing if there is exculpatory evidence available, and let the chips fall where they may.
So you're not judging Hank whether innocent or guilty. You just want the DNA to be at least entered.
That's correct. I think Hank has a compelling case of innocence. And again, the state of Texas has an obligation when they come before the public and say that this crime was so atrocious that the man who committed it should be subjected to execution. He should lose his life for that. I believe that they have an obligation to test every piece of available evidence to make sure they've got the right guy.
Hank says he's an innocent man. Let's listen to him in his own words.
I don't want to die for something I didn't do. As far as how I feel about it, I think about it all day, every day. I mean, how can you reconcile yourself to die for something you didn't do? You know, I mean, it's impossible. If I were guilty, then I'd at least have the luxury of saying, well, hell, I've done it, so this is what I get, you know what I mean? But I don't even have that luxury because I didn't do it. I'm innocent. That's all I need to say. You know, you're about to kill an innocent man. Do you even care?
All right, Sandrine, you weren't there. How can you be so convinced he didn't do it?
Well, I think, unfortunately, a number of media have totally misrepresented his case. It's not what he is saying or what I'm saying. The facts of the case exist to prove that the little that was tested prior to trial excluded him. The little that was tested, thanks to David Protest, during the appellates, the post-conviction appeals, exclude him, and that it is just mind-boggling that evidence preserved from the crime scene 15 years later, including the murder weapons, a rape kit, nail clippings from one of the victims, a male jacket that doesn't fit its size at all, with sweat, hair, DNA, to this day is not tested. I mean, it's just... I'm convinced of his innocence not because I love him and he's my husband. I'm convinced of his innocence also because beside the DNA issue, there is scientific forensic evidence to prove that he was not even in a state to stand up at the time of the crime, let alone murder three people that he loved. There is absolutely no motive. At the trial, the only thing that got him sentenced to death was a state witness who was threatened very seriously and recanted 2 years later and explained how she was threatened and, you know, withdrew her testimony at trial. That was the only thing that got him sentenced to death.